Hello, my name is Doug Hubble and welcome to Astrophotography Tutorials. Today we're going to talk about do-it-yourself digital picture frame, part 3. In part 3 we're going to discuss ways on how to mount your digital picture frame on the wall. If you haven't seen part 1 or part 2, you should go back and see those now. This will explain how to get the digital picture frame moving like you see here.
I found this little case kit that I want to try to use to mount the Raspberry Pi inside of this little case. I got this case kit from eBay. I think it was like $5. It took a little while to get. It came from China or somewhere overseas. But we're going to use that to mount the Raspberry Pi. The next thing we have is we have an articulating wall mount arm. I'm going to use this instead of trying to put the digital picture frame inside of a frame. I'm just going to use the framing that's naturally around the monitor and then just use this articulating wall mount. This thing wasn't that expensive. It was about, I think, $16 or $17 on Amazon. The plan, I don't know if this is going to work or not, but I've got some Velcro sticky that I plan on trying to adhere to the back of the case to mount it to the back of the monitor there. And the last thing I have here is a light control motion sensor switch, and this is what's going to turn the digital picture frame on and off. And the reason why I decided to get this model is that it has a sensor that is separate from the actual switch, and what this will allow me to do is it will allow me to plug this in a concealed area, have the motion sensor out, and this motion sensor is supposed to have a 20-minute timer on it. So this way when people walk into the room or there's constant motion in the room, the digital picture frame will continue to display and it won't be consuming energy just displaying when no one's there to watch it. So that's the plan. Let's see how this all comes together. Little 3-outlet tap to go inside here. Of course, this has only one outlet on it. I need 2 outlets. I need one outlet for the monitor, and then I also need another outlet for the power source for the Raspberry Pi.
Inside of it, it's a nice little case. It keeps it well protected from shorting out anything. It also has a ventilated top here over this CPU chip, so it keeps it cool. And it's very easy to assemble. You just kind of follow the outlines of it right here along the edge, and you can see where the different cutouts are made for the different devices. And it just lines up really easily. You just kind of snap it together. It's got these little snaps on the end, and before you know it, you have yourself a little Raspberry Pi case.
4 screws that hold the monitor stand to the monitor. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to remove these screws because I'm going to replace the monitor stand with an articulating wall mount arm flat on the table surface here. And what I did is I removed the screws from the back side here, and now I have a good place to mount the articulating arm. I'll mount this plate onto the back side of the monitor. And in this particular arm here, there's 2 screws that we'll need to remove to keep it, to separate it from the arm, because we're going to have to mount the arm separate. And this also has, on the very top here, these little pegs where you can actually just set it down. And the important thing, of course, is to make sure that these 2 little holes here at the top are actually at the top, and the 2 little screws are at the bottom, so when you go to mount it, these little fingers will go up into here and hold it in place. The original plan was to take the Raspberry Pi and then use some Velcro, and I thought it'd be a good idea to maybe stick it on the back side here to back of the monitor. But now that I think about it more and more, the heat would probably melt the adhesive off and then it would fall down. After I got the articulating arm on here, I noticed that there's this center arm here that as it moves in and out, it kind of stays together. So what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to take the Raspberry Pi and use wire ties and just hang on to it there right at the back. Well, that should keep it out of the way, and when it's completely flat and it's up against there, there's not much of a space that goes between it. It's almost completely level there. So that's the plan I'm going to use now. RaspberryPI mounted to the articulating arm. You can see that it's loose inside there. It doesn't have to be very tight. I mean, all we're doing is keeping it back behind the monitor frame. And what I'm hoping that I've done here is I took the HDMI, and what I'm going to do with the HDMI is I'm going to run that on the inside part, and with the inside part coming down and maybe wrapping back around into here, into the back. So that's the plan so far. It's just loosely held on. It's so that you can actually shut it. When it's shut completely against the wall like that, it's basically almost completely flat. I think that should work pretty good. Mock-up of the wires all in place on the table here. There's my HDMI cable. It's coming out a little bit below the bottom here. I might try bending that up a little bit, maybe with a wire tie, like bending it up like that to get it out of the way. Again, all the wires come up all around back behind the articulating arm and back to the RaspberryPI. Then all I have coming out of the bottom here are these two wires. One is the power for the RaspberryPI, and the other power is for the monitor. Took the HDMI cable, made a little bend on it, took another wire tie, and put it on the bottom there. That kept it from being exposed as a big loop down at the bottom. Then it comes all the way back up underneath here and goes to the RaspberryPI. And there's everything. There's the power right there. Power cable going right to it. So now the next step is to find a place to put it on the wall.
Okay, that seemed to work all right. The first hole right here is just a regular hole, but the bottom hole down here has an elongated hole. So what I'll do next is I'll get my level out and make sure it's level, and then put in that last hole. There it is, mounted on the wall. I think the stories of people complaining about the bolts breaking, I think they were just tightening them too tight. I found a stud and used a 7/32nd drill, and those things fit in there really nice, didn't over tighten them. It's held on the wall nice and tight. So the next step I have to do is get it mounted onto the frame here. I really like this articulating arm. It does a great job. I mean, you can put it the monitor anywhere you'd like. And I was first thinking about putting this thing in a picture frame, but now that I've got it on the wall, this is great. You know, you can take it and move it to any location you'd like in the room, and you can tilt it, move it up and down, whatever you'd like. So I think this is a much better decision to mount it on the articulating arm than it would be mounting it in a picture frame. And it's a heck of a lot cheaper. Just the like one of those shadow box frames alone, you're talking $35-40. This little articulating arm was only like $17. So I think it's a very good decision. And the way of putting that RaspberryPI in the back here turned out to work out really well. As the arm moves with the back side here, just having those wire ties loosely attached to the arm, it gives it the mobility and the flexibility to kind of move when it needs to. So I thought that was a much better decision than doing Velcro.
Next step is to get this motion sensor light switch with the outlets set up. What I did is I got this outlet plug. This is my power for the RaspberryPI right here, and this is my monitor power. And what it will do then is on the back side of this switch here, you can see there's settings for 1 minute, 2 minute, 5 minute, 10 minute, and 20 minute. I'm gonna try mine initially out at 20 minute intervals, And that way, if there's any motion within that 20 minute period, it'll continue the slideshow and then stop. This should help conserve some power. And when people aren't in the room, then the power or the slideshow will just turn off. Also, this little motion sensor thing that comes with it is very, very nice. It has mounting screws on the back that you can do, and it has these mounting screw and pads that are inside of here. What I can do is hide this big, ugly power device away, and then take this nice little tiny motion sensor device and maybe put it out somewhere with its cord out from back behind, and that way it'll look a little nicer.
Well, there you go. I have it mounted on the wall, and I'm very happy with the results of this articulating arm. I'm so glad I chose this instead of using a shadow box and trying to mount it. It's so easy to mount on the wall. You can move it around. If you have another couch or something in the room that you want to point it at, or maybe you just want to move it up or down to any kind of position you like, you have the ability to move it around. And it's a very easy way to mount your digital picture frame. I highly recommend it. The one thing I would suggest is the power cable that's on the back. One I purchased was a little bit too short. I think I'm going to look for a longer USB cable. But other than that, I really enjoy the setup, especially with the little motion sensor. I can put this anywhere I'd like. Whenever there's traffic in the room, then it automatically starts. And then when there's nobody in the room, it turns off. So it's very energy efficient. If this is the first time you're watching, I would like you to subscribe. I publish 2 astrophotography videos on the 1st and 15th every month. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you soon.